You're serving me up? I love that.
So good.
Hey, good morning, everyone, and welcome to Real Estate It's That Simple with Phil and Taylor. The Phil and Taylor Show. I think that sounds so much better, doesn't it?
Aw, wholesome.
Yep, and we are on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live. I am your friend in the real estate business, Phil Nordella, and Taylor Williams is your friend in the attorney business.
If there is such a thing.
I'm not sure whether
we try, but fair enough.
How would you like me? Well, we'll figure that out.
Yeah, we'll figure that out.
Yep. Hi.
Hi. How are you? Good morning. I'm so much better. Last week, I feel like I was on the struggle bus because you weren't here.
Last week was cool.
I think it was okay, but it's much better when you're here. I'm serious.
Look at that. Goosebumps.
Could
be the weather. Hang on a second. No, let's talk. The struggle bus.
The struggle bus.
That sounds like a kid's cartoon book. The struggle bus.
I do have a 3-month-old, so like maybe. Yeah. I don't want my son to know about the struggle bus, though, because you don't want him to be on the struggle bus.
Oh, yeah. So maybe the struggle bus is a bad thing.
Yeah. But that's what I felt.
Talking about children's books in what, 2 weeks?
I know.
Dallas Reigns with his lovely wife, Danny.
3 weeks, I think.
3 weeks?
3 weeks.
Yeah, December 3rd.
December 3rd.
They're going to come here because Dallas and Danny wrote a book. It's a children's book.
Yeah.
It's called Chester and the Hot Air
Balloon.
And Chester's their dog.
I ordered it last night.
And it's all about Chester going up with Dallas into a hot air balloon. And they get all sorts of storms and stuff, and
he loves them. Obviously, as a meteorologist.
When you guys were at the house, he and Greg, I know. They just bonded. Yeah. I was a little jealous, I'll be honest. I didn't have anything to
Chester's
talk about.
Chester's a great name.
I love that.
And it's a cute little dog too.
Yeah.
So it's awesome.
That will be delivered this weekend, but we're excited about that.
Yes, and I feel better now. I'm better now. I was on my deathbed last week.
You were not on your deathbed.
Actually, I was fine. By the way, I was tested and everything was fine. I was negative, but I did get a chest cold, which nowadays you get a chest cold and you're like, uh-oh, what's going on? But yes, I am. But Nick and Lance came into town, which is awesome, from Texas. They asked where you were from.
Dallas.
He said, I thought you said Dallas. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So he's at the Four Seasons. He's doing great. He's been able to take care of, Elon Musk, Elton John, Bruce Springsteen, just to name a few so far. And he just started.
Man.
They're giving him all
what
of
a life.
The really, they're, for some reason, I don't know, maybe because he doesn't get affected by the stars and everything, because he's done a lot of acting work.
Yeah, even keeled.
They're giving him all of the top
people,
which is
kind
of fun.
And hopefully they're polite and whatnot to him.
You know what? They're great.
So far, so good.
Yeah.
Would you tell us if they weren't, though?
I don't know if he would tell me.
And see, that's why he's good.
Yeah. But you know what? I mean, there's nothing offensive about him whatsoever.
At all.
He's such a great kid.
He's
like a chameleon.
You can't. Yeah. Everybody likes him. Exactly. Yeah. No way.
Cool. I love my kids.
Yeah.
I think I'll keep them.
I think I'll keep them.
You did a good job.
Aw, thank you. Nice. Hey, some fun stuff going on.
Yeah, we got a lot, as always.
Yes, we do.
Where do you want to start?
This kind of tickles me a little bit. At the end of the show, we're going to go back to Zillow. But as of right now, it's kind of funny because remember Showing Time?
Absolutely.
That Zillow bought for $500 million?
Yes.
Well, it's starting already. So all of these different companies are coming out with this new thing, Showing Time, to take over for it. Now, Showing Time, in case you've forgotten, is if you get on the MLS and you decided that you want to be able to have somebody click on something to where they can set up the appointment
right through the MLS
to go see the property. Yeah. They don't have to call you directly. I prefer they call me directly because I want to know who's going. But Zillow, who I hate, bought Showing Time for $500 million. And the reason why no one wants to use them anymore is because it has an area where you can fill it out and give the client's names. So what you're doing is you're giving your buyer and your sellers all the information to your clients.
Exactly.
And it's like, that's the last people because now they're in competition.
They're going to call, and it's messed up.
So anyway, it's funny because Houston's got 45,000 agents. Their new showing platform's called Showing Smart. Okay.
Tennessee,
18,000 agents. They've got a new thing called a platform called Real Tracks. And I'm sorry, that delights me.
Why does it delight you? Because there's competition for Zillow?
Because less stuff actually. You know, Zillow has become a behemoth, and they're actually they're our competition now.
Right.
It used to be, it's not a big deal. They offered something. It was great. Now they're our competition. Now they actually have agents, and we'll talk about them at
the
end of the show.
Okay. Yep. So there's other states, though, that are creating their own platforms to do basically what Showing Time did.
Exactly.
That's
right.
Not Zillow's.
That's
right?
Not Zillow's.
So we're happy
and
about
I'm just kind of hoping now that they actually got out of the iBuying business, and now maybe that $500 million that went out to Showing Time's not going to do that great either. So.
That's what it sounds like.
And it sounds like that I'm upset with Zillow, and it that's true, and I'll go over that.
We'll get there.
Yep. Okay, mm-hmm. Things that make you want to go, hmm.
Ooh. Patty was on that.
We talked.
And now it's time for things that make you go, hmm.
We may have talked before.
It's
possible.
I was
about to say, don't. Just let me give the man a compliment. Don't. You know?
I mean, yes. Thank you.
He is
on
right
my game.
On it. Good job. Excellent job. Okay, so here's the situation. You know, my son called me up. He lives in Washington.
Which
and
one?
He goes, Brian. So he lives in Washington. He just got a house. 6 weeks later, the heater goes down. And this is just a thing that says, you know what? Not all home warranty companies are the same.
We love
First American Home Warranty.
Absolutely.
American Home Shield is their big competitor. They do radio advertising there in every state. Blah, 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 blah. So he called me up and he says, this is what's going on. And I went, okay, this is bad. So my
this
son Brian
no
bought an American Home Shield home warranty in the state of Washington. As luck would have it, his heater went down. And they said that they would come out. And even though they were going to charge him money, which is makes sense because they needed to replace the actual heater, they were going to replace it. And so they said it would take 6 to 8 weeks to get it. And he called after about 5 weeks and said, hey, you know, you guys haven't actually called me. Now, it's cold up there. Right.
I was about to say that's a long time to wait for a heater. Yeah. Like cold showers are not my thing. So,
exactly
yeah.
right. So, now this isn't a water heater. This is a heater.
Oh, heater.
Yeah.
Oh, but still.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. So you get out of the shower and then you're freezing.
It was 68 degrees.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you stay in the shower.
Which we think is cold in LA.
Exactly. Which is freezing. Are you kidding? And so anyway, so they said, oh, I'm sorry. Your order was canceled. And he goes,
and no one called to tell him that the order was canceled.
Well, this is why no one called. He goes, well, when he asked why it was canceled, they said, because it was never ordered. Things that make you go, how does something that was never ordered get canceled? So
I'm
just wondering.
I wonder who he spoke to. That's interesting.
So
did he ever get a heater?
Yeah, but he ended up having to just pay for it.
Just do it himself.
Yep. He said, okay. He goes, I can go with the same company that they said was still going to be 6 to 8 weeks. I can get from the same company. It's going to cost me a little bit more, but I can get it tomorrow. Figure that one out.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Go get him.
Exactly.
Go get him, Taylor.
Yep. You see my brain. My brain's like, no.
She just had a look there that I went, oh, God, I like that. There was a spark there. So
not happening.
Anyway, so if you have an opportunity, do not go with American Home Shield. I'm sorry. It just doesn't sound like their service is that great. I'd say First American Home Warranty. You can call Don Zirbel. I guess that's a commercial for her.
Absolutely.
I actually talked to her and told her that story, and I said I was going to bag on American Home Shield. She goes, oh, I got to tune in. So if you're listening, Don, you know, that was for
you. Bagging.
Yep,
yeah,
exactly.
Right.
Okay, here's another thing.
Wow, okay.
The National Association of Realtors is now got a lot of members upset with them, and rightly so,
okay.
I think. So that you understand, the National Association of Realtors is the big realtor association. It's got like 1.3 million people that pay them a lot of money every single year.
To be a member, yeah.
And what did they decide to do? They decided to sell their realtor designation, because they actually made it up. Realtor.
Right.
Right?
Those are the commercials that you see about how home buying is so much better, and they have the little pin.
Yes,
because
exactly
they're a
right.
Realtor.
That's a realtor. Yeah.
Exactly.
Well, they sold that designation.
Uh-oh.
They could still use it, but they sold it also to a company in Australia.
Why?
So what? I have no idea.
We
it
don't
must
know?
Have been for a lot of money. But they did it in 2014.
Okay.
So this company in Australia decides, you know what, eventually, they just actually worked out a deal with Open Door. Which means that they're in bed with Open Door, and Open Door actually is a company that doesn't even want to use realtors. So what happens there? Now they've actually kind of screwed themselves, and the people from NAR, all of us members, are going, how dumb was that?
That doesn't make any sense.
No.
Interesting.
It's kind of stupid.
So I guess the issue is everybody's wondering, like, what the heck is happening, right?
Exactly right.
And there's no answers.
Nope. And Open Door thinks, and again, we're going to get to that at the end, Open Door thinks that they're the fair-haired child at the prom because they, because Zillow is not their competition anymore. And so that dropped off big time. So
I think, as much as we don't like Zillow.
Yes.
You know, there's still competition. They're still there.
No, Zillow's still a behemoth.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What they did was their iBuying situation was kind of like a cancer for them. Okay. Because they decided to buy a bunch of properties to see if they couldn't catch up to Opendoor, which had a, and they both have billions of dollars to spend.
Right.
And the mistake that they made was they decided that they'd buy 10,000 properties, and they ended up buying 15,000 properties and realized we can't even get these flipped now. We can't. We don't have people to work on them.
Exactly.
We can't get stuff.
Right.
And so,
what are we
going
to do with these? The carrying costs and whatnot.
Huge hole in their boat.
Yeah, exactly.
And so they said, we're going to get out.
Hole in their boat. That's good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, that happens.
Definitely.
Okay, next.
Wait.
Oh, yes.
We haven't done in... by the numbers and forever. Do we have numbers? Mm-hmm, no. Numbers. So we should probably do in the news.
And now, in
exactly.
The news.
Exactly.
But because that was initiated by Taylor.
Hey, guys and dolls. It's your favorite time of the show, Taylor Talk.
I like my dancing has gotten worse since I had a baby, which is weird because I like dance with him every night. But yeah.
Maybe he's going to be a professional dancer
as
when
he
goes
as long as
he
has my moves and not my husband's. Sorry, Greg. No offense. Anyway.
Well, you know, us guys, we've got two moves. It's this. That's
yeah.
about it. And we
That's
snap,
true.
Too.
Yeah.
And when you're a certain age, you have to snap.
You have
when
to
you
snap.
Do.
That's
I don't know. I
it like
think
keeps
it
you
it,
on beat.
Yeah, it
That's
gives
a,
it.
Yep.
One,
because it's
two.
Like you can't one, hear two. The beat, really. One, you got to make sure that one, it's in
out
your
of
ears.
Rhythm.
I was dancing with somebody I remember, and they went, "You like to snap?" And I went, "What do you mean? I don't snap." And I went, "Oh, yeah, I guess
oh
I do. I do
or
snap."
Or my dad does this number up and down.
Oh,
and up
no.
And down.
I just head bop.
I know, right?
I just do like the head bop. Like,
how about that?
Yeah, Greg doesn't do anything. Greg just stands there like,
Everybody that's listening is going, you realize we can't see you really unless
oh,
we're on
unless
Facebook,
you're Facebook
Live.
Yeah. Yeah. So my husband doesn't dance, but that was the face that I was making. So,
all right. That's
all right.
Awesome.
So we're in the news and Taylor talks. What you got?
Yes. Home showings don't equal procuring cause. Here's why.
Okay.
Now everybody's going, what the heck does that mean?
Okay.
All right. So here's the situation. This is an opinion piece from mm-hmm. Inman. They've got down here, read the arbitration manual, review the questions in the arbitration worksheet, and please stop proclaiming that simply showing a home entitles
heart.
You to compensation. It doesn't work
it
that way.
It does not right? work that way.
Now,
yeah.
I will be honest with you. For the longest time, not only did I go off of the fact, and I think there was a time that it worked, but all the other realtors out there said, look, if you show it, you've got procuring cause if they actually do. Now, I'm thinking
I'm shaking my head. You can't
long,
see me, but I'm shaking my head.
A long time ago, but that used to be the way that supposedly it worked.
A long, long time ago.
Long, long
ago.
Time ago, yes. Yes. In fact, I started
I
to think about
remember.
Something. There's something here that I'm going to talk about, and I put down the years, and I went, that's before she was born. Oh, my God.
Well, good. I hope we get there.
Oh, yeah, we will.
So, yes.
Okay, so here's the situation. So this is what you hear sometimes in real estate. I showed a home, and now the buyer wants to work with the listing agent. What can I do? Or how about this? Showed a buyer six homes. They ghosted me and bought a home through another agent. How about this one? After I showed my sister a home, this is a bad one, she decided to use her hairdresser, who's been a realtor for two weeks, to buy a home, claims they really need the business. Oh,
yeah. We can't say that.
I need the business too. I'm never talking to my sister again. Wow.
I hope it's not that serious.
Okay, so procuring cause basically is being able to say, look, I got screwed and I want to go to arbitration and say, I deserve the commission, not you. So let's just say I show you property, I show you property, I show you property. Finally, I show you something you really like and you call somebody that you know. That you were always planning on calling.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So I was just a shill.
Which right? I would never do to you, by the
no,
way.
No, absolutely. Yeah. And I appreciate that.
Although I'm thinking, like, who else could I call? I'm kidding.
So anyway, but, you know, that's the situation.
Correct.
And this
and
is,
unfortunately, that happens.
It used to happen a ton because people used to think that if they're an agent in, they would sell their clients a home in Encino or in the West Side.
Right.
And they want to move to Santa Clarita. They're going, I don't want to show property in Santa Clarita. I know. Call a realtor. You know, get them to work for you. You know, to have them tell you all about Santa Clarita.
And then
find
when
a house,
you're ready to close,
ready,
I've got you.
I'll jump in. Well,
exactly.
that's where procuring cause basically came from.
Right.
It was like, no, this is wrong. So some respondents dived into more detail, providing facts like you showed the home, you are the procuring cause. Or if you show the home or write the offer, you are the procuring cause. And entitled to a full commission. But then there is, if you have a buyer-broker agreement, you are
right.
automatically the procuring cause, which I find interesting that none of these are actually completely accurate, which cracks me up. And what I took from this was you can't just actually have the one thing. In other words, I can't show you a property and say, you're mine.
No.
Because I showed you that property.
Unless you and I have an agreement.
Yes. Now, but they're which even saying here, which is interesting, the buyer-broker agreement, they're even saying that's not enough sometimes, and that could be fought. So
there's a list of questions that are good, because this is what, again, it ultimately comes out to, you know, what is a court going to ask and what's it going to look at?
Sure. Okay. So what is procuring clause? As Quicken Loans simply explains, it's the actions made by a real estate agent that cause the buyer to purchase the home. It's as simple as it sounds. The actual process of providing that a realtor is procuring cause in a buyer buying a home is quite a bit more complex, involving arbitration. So, procuring now arbitration, is that something that you go without an actual attorney?
No, you would have an attorney for arbitration.
Good. Okay.
Yeah, there's no jury or anything like that. I mean, it's a legal proceeding, but it's like trial light, quote unquote.
And whatever they decide, that's it. I mean, is it one of those?
Depending on if
usually?
It's binding arbitration, which typically it is. Yes.
Okay.
Which, if you look at an RPA, typically has binding arbitration. So
it says procuring cause is a legal concept developed over many years by the courts. That alone should tell you it's not a simple concept. The legal definition does not does little to alleviate the confusion surrounding procuring cause. So okay. So let's just kind of go over.
Yes, that's a lot of legal mumbo jumbo.
Yeah.
As the article says.
Here's the interesting thing. They're saying showing a home is not a series of events, but you actually have to show a series of events and without breaking continuity.
Correct.
Which is interesting.
Correct.
So I'm not exactly sure how that would play out. Now, I get this. If you just had a buyer-broker agreement and then never showed them any property, then you're not entitled to anything,
fair.
Right? Because that's just a one event.
One event.
If you showed
isolated incident, if you will.
Multiple properties.
Yep.
And then they found something. Mm-hmm. Maybe that would help. Considering
absolutely.
That's a series of events.
Absolutely.
It's not just showing the one.
Exactly.
So if I ended up showing you 16 properties and then you called your sister-in-law, then that would be maybe I would have a chance.
Exactly.
I
agree.
Okay.
It's proximate cause, right? What is the reason that I purchased the property? You found it. You gave it to me. As a result, I purchased it. That's the question.
Look at you.
Why
I
is that
it.
Funny?
I
oh.
No, I do. Whenever you get into the kind of a little bit of the legalese, I'm just so proud.
Oh, thank you.
I'm like a proud papa.
Yep.
let's see. So here's some of the questions that they ask. It says, okay, let's start with this. But I showed the home. Without that, there wouldn't be a deal. That makes me the procuring cause.
No.
Wrong. It's more than that. Some of the questions hearing panels might use to determine procuring cause include sourced from various boards and organizations. Was the introduction of the property instrumental in creating the desire to purchase? Did the buyer know about the property before the broker actually contacted him? Did the buyer find, which is something that they would hang their hat on because they say, yeah, I saw it on Zillow, I saw whatever on Realtor.com, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, exactly.
Did the buyer find the property on his own? Was there a faithful exercise of the duties a broker owes to the client principal? Did the broker who made the initial introduction to the property engage in conduct or fail to some action which caused the purchaser or tenant to utilize the services of another broker?
Exactly.
In other words, you suck and I went somewhere else. Basically, right?
Yeah. So there's, I mean, that's, you know, it's a totality of the circumstances and all of these questions would be asked. Not, you know, these among others. But yeah, it's interesting.
Did the broker make continued efforts after showing the property? Did the broker remove an impediment to the sale?
Do you have this a lot? Have you had experience with this?
Never had it ever.
Okay.
I've had agents come up to me when I was owning my company going, I showed it, and they had da-da-da-da-da, and I said, well, yeah, we'll just take them to arbitration, I guess, and I would hand it over to our broker.
Got it.
And let them take care of it.
Handle it.
But
right.
Then all of a sudden, I got to a point where somebody actually came over and said, what do you think? And I said, I think you've got a case. And then I talked to somebody else, and they went, they don't have a case. And I went, oh, okay.
Well, so, and again, the question that we talk about all the time is what are the damages, right? How much was the commission, all that fun stuff. So,
which is another thing that we're going to get into when it comes to insurance and stuff like that.
I know. Yeah, but in the meantime, I think we have to take a break.
Already?
What should we sell today? Couches. That sounds good.
Couches.
I need a new couch. So that, you know, the first thing that came to mind. But we'll just take a brief break for the couches, and then we'll be back.
We'll sell a couch.
Yep.
Okay. See you in a minute. Haunting through my soul, so cynical. So you're a tough guy, like you're really rough guy. Just
just can't get enough, guy. Just always so puff, guy. I'm that bad type, make your mama sad.
If you're thinking of selling your home, have Phil Nordella come out and give you a free, no obligation, property valuation. Just call 661-312-3561. It's that simple.
Let's talk about insurance. Are your rates skyrocketing year after year? Or do you feel like you would benefit from a professional advisor that works for you? Give the great team at Voy Insurance Solutions a call. Voy works with dozens of the best insurance companies to help you obtain competitive rates and comprehensive coverage. Homeowners, auto, business, and life insurance. Voy Insurance. Right price, right coverage, right now. Mention the Phil Nordella Show and get a free $10 Starbucks card. Visit voyinsurance.com. That's voyinsurance.com.
If you're looking for an SEV-based home design firm you can trust, look no further. Style My Space is a recognized leader in luxury vacant home staging and interior design projects for all of Northern Los Angeles County since 2006. Their five-star reputation for beautiful staging installations helps sellers realize up to 10% higher offers in as little as one-third the time as non-staged homes. Get an instant quote on our website at stylemyspace.com. That's stylemyspace.com.
Marla Ferris at Augusta Financial is the consummate mortgage professional, committed to helping you turn your dream of homeownership into reality. With more than 22 years in the finance mortgage industry, Marla brings extensive experience and top knowledge to help make your loan experience hassle-free. Given her honesty, integrity, and attention to detail, she is the loan officer you can trust. Marla knows what it takes to get you the best loan, the best rate, and the best service in the industry. You'll find Marla Ferris at MarlaFerris.com.
Castle Inspection is the top choice for home inspection in Santa Clarita. With over 20 years experience, make Castle Inspection your choice when buying your new condominium or home. From mobile homes to mansions, the outhouse to the penthouse, your best bet is a net from Castle Inspection. An inspection is a fair and objective evaluation of the home's physical and mechanical systems. Expert knowledge, thorough research, and clear communication are what sets a net at Castle above the rest. Schedule your appointment online now at castleinspection.com.
Are you confused with all the craziness that's going on with the real estate market these days? Well, if you are, you're not alone. I'm Phil Nordella, and I have the knowledge and experience to help guide you through all the confusion. I'll answer your questions and help advise you so that you can accomplish your real estate goals. You can call me directly at 661-312-3561 or get online at philnordella.com. And don't forget, you can always listen to my radio show called Real Estate It's That Simple here on KHTS every Friday morning at 10 a.m. Phil Nordella, EXP Realty, it's that simple.
Your hometown station.
KHTS is the only station I listen to.
98.1 FM and AM 1220.
Hey, okay. Welcome back to Real Estate It's That Simple on KHTS, 1220 AM and 98.1 FM, and on Facebook Live. We didn't wait, everybody. By the way, I've got a question for you.
Yes, I was snapping.
Oh, yeah.
To the beat. That's why I was laughing. Yep, dun, 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 dun.
Never going to live that one down. All righty.
What is the question?
Does Greg mention ever now that we don't actually say, how's Triple G, but we asked, how's Big C now?
You know? No, I think it's normal.
Yeah.
Like, no one asks how I'm doing. How's the baby? How's the baby? So it's just, you know, par for the course.
Okay. So we should ask, how is Triple G?
He's flying. I assume he's okay. Well, I hope so. I mean, I think I would have heard if it was, you know, otherwise. He's good. I think he gets back home tomorrow at some time.
Does he ever tell you actually where he's going, or does he just say, I'll talk to you on Friday?
So am I allowed to say HE double hockey sticks on the air? Maybe not. So we have a calendar on our fridge that says where the HE double hockey sticks is Greg. And it's a whiteboard.
That's funny.
And he fills it in every month. So I know exactly where he's flying.
That's funny.
Yeah. And then he sends it to me. I print it. And then I put it on my desk at my office also. So if anybody asks where he is, I can like, and then I can scramble and figure out the airport code. And that's where he is. So
that's awesome. That's fun.
That's so cute. It's funny.
I mean, it works because people ask me all the time, where is he? I'm like, I don't know. I'm like, I should know, right? So
you'd think. You'd think.
Well, but see, I have a lot to keep track of.
But see, if you don't write that down, because he goes so many places, you know, he could leave and say, okay, bye. And normally it'd be like, bye, honey, I'll see you at 5 o'clock. It's not, bye, honey, I'm going to so-and-so.
I'll see you on Wednesday afternoon.
And then you'll go, where did he say he went?
Exactly. Yeah. And then people ask me, and then they're like, you're a horrible wife. You don't know where your husband is? I'm like, no, I don't.
Let's break it down. How did he pack? Did he pack for, like, cold weather or
I know,
warm
exactly.
weather?
I don't pay attention. I don't know. At least 4 in the morning. Like, I don't know. Greg, I'm sorry.
You want to hear something terrible? Judy usually packs for me.
Oh.
Not all the time. Not all the time. I think, but she's just so great.
I think Greg and I will get there because I basically buy everything that he wears. So it's like he'll ask me, like, what do you want me to bring? And I'm like, bring this, bring. So it's the same thing. I'm just not folding anything.
My mom does that for my dad, too.
I thought you were going to say for you. And I was like, Patty, take your ears off. We have a need to have a conversation.
No. I pack my own stuff.
Well, no, I pack usually my clothes. What she does is she goes in and gets all my toiletries and stuff like that and vitamins and stuff. And she'll put it all.
Oh, that's
in.
Nice.
Yeah, no, it's nice.
Judy's
and the
a
other
gem,
thing,
man.
Oh, are you kidding?
She's
no,
a
no,
gem.
No, no,
I
no.
love her.
Yeah, I scored. But what she, another thing she'll do, though, is she usually puts my shirts and stuff because when the way she folds them, she puts them in. They come out. I don't really even have to.
You know what?
Iron them.
Greg does all the folding and stuff for us.
Me?
Greg is amazing.
He's the folder.
Yeah, he does our laundry. He does the folding. Like he's a wonderful.
He knows when to hold them and he knows when to fold them.
Amen. Oh. But he doesn't know where to hang them. But that's fine.
I want a little credit for that one.
That was good.
You get credit.
I think that was wonderful. I think that was so good.
Okay. So I decided to write a little something up here.
Yeah.
Because this is the time
something.
Of year. I know. This is the time of year that people say, you know what? I think I want to try a new profession.
And when you sent me this, I'm so happy that we're talking about this because I think this is so poignant and this happens all the time.
Yeah, and there's quite a few takeaways from this because what people think a new realtor does opposed to what we do.
So they think they want to change their profession and they want to get into real estate,
exactly
right? That's
right.
What
you
we're talking
why?
About.
Because realtors make so much money.
Absolutely.
And we're all very, very rich.
And you get
and
to control
know.
Your schedule.
Exactly. And all we do is show pretty homes.
Yep.
And then they
so,
close and we get a commission.
So easy.
That's it. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I decided to actually go a little bit back, tell my story and tell, you know, the good, the bad, the ugly.
Right.
Okay. That's just the way it is. Okay. So
I'm excited about this.
Oh, this is where it came up. 40 years ago, I got into the alarm business. 40 years ago, before you were born, I got in. I started my own business, my first one.
Good for
okay,
you.
Okay. Opened my own company and sold over 2,000 alarm systems, right? Mm-hmm. And I sold the company when I was 30 and pseudo retired, kind of, sort of. I played a lot of golf after that. I opened up movie
you have
production
to say,
company.
I played a lot of golf, and
I
then I opened up.
Yeah,
at the age of 30.
And I'll tell you something. Playing two years worth of golf makes you really feel worthless. I felt worthless because I wasn't doing all the things that I was doing before when I was building it.
And
you can't
so,
retire at 30. So I decided, exactly. You know what, it's time to get back into sales. I love sales. I enjoyed it. I thought, you know what, what's a higher ticket sale than an alarm system? Now, an alarm system at the time were $3,800, right? So you could make $1,900 on an alarm system, which was great.
That's a lot of money.
But now they're free. And so, yeah, they're doing it just for the monitoring now. So anyway, I digress. So I decided to get into real estate. No one really gave me an idea what to expect. I jumped into it head first, even though everyone was telling me at the time in 1993 that everyone was getting out of real estate because nothing was selling, which was actually true. And they said that I was crazy. Okay.
I can see that. Fair.
I didn't know any better.
Okay.
Here's the situation, though. If I wasn't in a position that I was in, I would have failed.
Okay.
And the position that I was in, I'll go over it. So now, that was it was very dangerous for your average person. I'm not saying I'm better than the average person. What I am saying is that I had some things that I had that most people didn't have. Okay. But if they don't have this information and they get into this field, it could be disastrous to them, their family, and their bank account, which is not a good thing. Okay.
Correct.
So I had a couple things going for me most people in getting real estate don't have. I was lucky enough to have 9 years worth of sales experience and almost $2 million in the bank.
Mm-hmm.
That was kind of nice. Okay. I also had
prospecting
experience. I had in-home presentation experience and I had money. Okay. Without those things, it would have been very difficult.
Definitely.
And so anyway, when I got into real estate, the average marketing time in 1993, the average marketing time, which means if you actually are lucky enough to get a listing, the average marketing time was 7 months.
That long?
7 months.
Wow.
Okay. So,
gosh, and right now,
Patty,
what,
I'm going to ask you to do the math on this one. So in 1993, if you decided that you wanted to get licensed, okay, it was going to take you between 3 and 4 months to actually study to get licensed. Okay, now your license, you hang your license with a company. Okay, let's just say you're lucky enough to get your first listing within 3 months. Okay, throw that in there. Now, 7 months to get it into escrow.
We're at 13 months.
13 months. Yes. Now add another 90 days for escrow.
Okay.
Escrows weren't 30 days, they were 90. What are we at now?
16 months.
16 months.
Okay, so now tell me, exactly right. Now you start January 1993 and you decide to actually get your first paycheck. When's it coming in?
April of 1994.
Good job.
Yeah.
Good
I know job. That because that's the fourth month and that's my birthday month. That's how I know April. You're lucky. Or I'm lucky. That's what
good
it is.
Job. Good job. Ding, 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 ding.
But for a lot of people, that's not sustainable.
That's crazy. They're saying, goodness. Okay, get ready to study, and your first check is going to come in 14 months, 15 months.
Yeah.
That's not good.
Yeah. No, that's not unless good. You're in school and getting, you know, tuition yep. money or something.
But
like that.
The good
yeah.
thing about that is, I mean, what makes it worse is you can spend a ton of money in that year and a half yes. trying to push yourself, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So that's so now
that's crazy.
So I'm not gonna. It's not all bad because things have changed a lot, right? It still takes the same amount of time to get licensed. However, if you're lucky enough to get a listing within 3 months, the chances are it's going to sell within a week now, if not 7 months.
Exactly.
Okay, so that actually and escrows are no longer 90 days; they're 30 days, yeah. sometimes 45. So that's a really good thing. Okay, so this is the good news. Let's go over the realization that the things that to think about. That if you're thinking of changing careers at the beginning of 2022, I'm sure everyone's heard.
This is what you want to think about. Yes. Yeah, this is good.
I'm sure everyone's heard about the fact that all realtors make a ton of money. Yeah, 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 yeah. I don't want to discourage anybody, but.
Not all realtors.
No. I feel you need to have all the information to make the important decision to change careers. Let's break it down a little bit and give you the behind the curtain look at what it takes to be a new realtor. First thing that you need to understand is that after you studied for 3 months and take your test and you successfully passed your test, which you're very, very grateful to do, you still know absolutely nothing about selling real estate or the real estate business.
Absolutely.
Zero.
Absolutely.
Okay. It's almost embarrassing. It's stupid. It doesn't make any sense whatsoever.
It's not real life practice.
They give you information that you'll never, ever use except for one thing.
Which is?
How big is an acre? How big is an acre? It's 43,560 square feet. That's okay. The only thing you'll ever use. The only reason why you use it is because if somebody says, hey, this has got a 22,000 square foot lot, you can say, oh, that's about a half an acre. That's the only time you'll use it, and that's
look
how stupid
at
it is.
That.
Oh yeah, no, that's
wow.
that's crazy. All right.
Okay.
So that's the only time you'll ever use it.
Okay.
So let's
so that's
break.
Good to know.
Let's break what you need to know after that. Right. You got your license. First thing is, you got to start with the contracts. Right?
Yay.
I mean, you're pro
my
contract,
bread and butter.
Right? Although there's probably only about 20 contracts you actually need to actually know about when it comes to fill out to complete a transaction. There's over 300 contracts in CA forms, in the CAR forms.
CAR.
Any of which could be needed at any given time.
Right.
Okay.
And you need to know which ones to use
exactly
at any given time.
Exactly right. Yep. Yeah, you betcha. Okay. Yep. Next thing, you need to know how to prospect. Hey, which means you're going to be doing a lot of things that you're not really going to want to do, like make cold calls.
Mm-hmm.
Like, hi, just wanted to know when you folks plan on moving. Don't ever call me again, slam. Okay, how about this? Knock doors. Hi, I'm Phil Nordella. Sorry to bother you. I know you're busy. I was just wondering when you folks plan
you
on moving.
You have a beautiful house. I know you guys probably will want to get a larger one. At
yes.
what point in time
and
do you want to
move? If you don't
move
out, I'm going to just camp out on your doorstep.
I don't think you have time for that, but yes. And that's true. And
yep.
that's difficult. It's difficult for a lot of people.
You know, I can't tell you how many times people have come into my first training class when I was owning the company, and I say, okay, so what are we going to do prospecting-wise? What's prospecting? Well, we've got to find you some clients, right? So they're like, oh, what do you think? Well, these are the things that you have to work for, and they kind of glass over, and it's like, I don't want to do any of those things.
No one does, but
well,
it has
okay.
to be done.
Well, you can sit at home and wait by the phone. You'll be the best-kept secret in town, right?
But that is that's an important part.
Absolutely.
Unfortunately.
Not to mention, you can either go out and work for it and do sweat equity, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or you can buy it. So, I mean, unless you've got a lot of money, you're not going to be making a lot of money, but you're going to be spending a lot of money, which is tough. Another thing that they need
right.
to know is it takes money, hard work, persistence, and patience.
Of course.
A lot of hard work, a lot of persistence, you know. And so after you get a listing appointment, so you prospect and prospect and prospect, and here's the spiral that's really tough.
So then you find me who wants to sell my house.
Yes, exactly
right.
Right. So guess what? You're like, yay. And you go out there and you go, I have no idea what to tell you, right? So my company is a really good company, and I've, you know, being full disclosure, I've never sold a house in my life, but I'd like for you to let me try to sell your house, and you know it's going to be one of the biggest transactions you'll ever have in your life. But please, exactly.
Yeah, no, not happening.
It makes it
you
tough.
And if you're on Facebook Live, you should have seen Phil's face. He's like deer in headlights. Which even that, I'm like, nope.
Yeah,
yeah, absolutely. It's my largest asset. Why am I going to go with you if you've never sold one
exactly.
before?
Exactly. And you know, and you'll go up somebody like against somebody like me who's been doing it 30 years. It's almost 1,000 homes. Got the real estate radio show I used to own. And it's like, okay. It's hard to compete with
them. Yeah, to get in there. Absolutely.
And so they just have to understand that, and they have to find their own niche, and they've got to be able to, you know,
be personable and navigate it and find a way to sell themselves, right?
Exactly.
That's what I would assume.
So now if you're not lucky enough to get a listing, in the beginning you have no idea what to do with it.
Yep.
Okay. Much less get the contracts filled out properly.
Mm-hmm. Well, I would do that for you in this scenario.
Yes, thank
right?
you very much.
I'm just saying, if you're brand new.
Can you imagine that?
No.
I'm like, hi, I've never sold a house, but if you want to list with me, could you just fill out the contracts? I have no idea what they're doing. Okay. So therefore, if you do get a listing, right, and you fill out the contracts, you need to have somebody that's going to do all the work for
Absolutely.
You.
Absolutely.
So you have to have some kind of a mentor or a sales manager or a trainer or something like that.
That's now, here's, been there before.
Here's
yes.
the problem.
Okay.
Here's the problem. So your average company, their trainer is what I call a failed agent. What?
That's sad.
Well, think about it. A really good agent that really knows what they can do can make $200,000, $300,000, $600,000, $700,000 a year in commissions.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so they're that's great.
Absolutely.
The trainers that we used to have used to come to us and say, I'm really struggling. I can't make any sales. Can I actually make some money as a trainer for
Interesting.
You?
Interesting. I would have thought the opposite. I thought, you know, I would have
you
thought
would think.
Yeah, that they would have been paid the big bucks because they know what they're doing. They're tired of doing the prospecting. They don't want to go out. They don't want to show homes. They just want to teach.
Yeah, failed agents are usually the ones that are teaching, which is a really bad thing.
Hope
right?
none are listening because they're not going to like that opinion.
But. But, I mean, if you think about it, and that's just a fact because of we had failed agents come and actually asked to be our trainers. And one of my recruiting things was getting agents to come to us opposed to other companies was I was saying, I'm doing a lot of the training and I'm a top producer.
Mm-hmm.
So I can teach you to become a top producer.
Got it.
I can't tell you to be mediocre. I can only tell you how to be a top producer.
So you're saying find a spot where the trainer is somebody that has, you know, is reputable or whatnot. Because
exactly.
that's going to help.
Exactly
okay.
right.
That makes sense.
So
good to know.
Oh, by the way, also in the beginning, if you go to a company and they say, well, our commission split 60-40, right? When normally it could be 100% or it could be 80-20, could be 70-30. If it's 60-40 for the first six deals, it's because there's going to be somebody that's going to do all the work for you.
Okay.
And so we used to have that too. We used to be on a 60-40. And so that the person was actually taking it and getting the ball across the goal line was going to be making some decent money. And
okay.
it's not
well, that's good to know.
Which makes sense, right?
The specifics. So make sure you know what you're getting into.
Exactly. What's some of the other things? You need to memorize scripts, multiple dialogues for both buyers and sellers. Your scripts
Absolutely.
And dialogues might get you into a listing presentation, but then you have to be able to present, and that's very difficult. I always say a prospect, you know what? Prospecting can actually get you into the batter's box, but if you can't hit a curveball. And that's what's so frustrating.
Look at that.
Because you prospect and prospect and prospect, and you get a listing appointment, and you don't get it. They say no. But they'll never tell you no, by the way. They'll always, and I always tell my new agents, this is what they'll tell you. You know what? Thank you so much. You are so professional. That was concise. You're terrific. You know, you're really terrific. Oh, great. Am I going to get the listing? No.
I'm not sure, but bless your heart.
Exactly right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. then, excuse me. Then, if you're lucky enough to get a listing, you need to know, if you actually get the listing, you need to know all the listing protocols, such as contracts, lockbox, sign, photos, videos, MLS information. Don't forget to add the fact that if you do get an offer or multiple offers, you need to know how to counter them to be able to maximize the profits for your sellers.
Exactly. Communicate them, counter them. Yep.
You have to be able to be adept at tracking the escrow, negotiate the home warranty, physical inspection, and timeframes of all the contract. And the same if you find a buyer.
Absolutely.
Okay. So you need to know how to show property and to point out not only the positives. That's what people think. You're a salesman. I'm always going to try and sell you something, right? Which is terrible. That's not it. It's
the last time you showed us a property, I think that was the most like the thing that we appreciated the most because you said, this is not good. You're not going to like this. You're not going to like this. And I'm like, okay,
yep.
This guy actually cares about what we want, right?
So I wrote that down.
That's you, this guy.
You know, I wrote it down here. It's not about showing a property and trying to talk people into buying it. Sometimes it's talking your buyers into not buying it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep.
And then you need to know how to write the offer and get them the ability to hopefully get them into escrow. The market is very competitive right now. And there's a lot of things that you have to make a decision on, such as when you do write an offer, is it competitive enough and does your client want it enough to where they're going to waive the appraisal?
Right.
Sometimes.
Which is a huge deal.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes, you know, we've even had people waive the home inspection, which I don't recommend.
I don't recommend that either. you should see my face. I'm like, don't do
it. Sometimes, you know, here the interesting thing, you think, well, it's a brand new house. It's not a big deal. I sold a brand new house down in Corona Del Mar, and there was more things wrong with that new house.
I can only imagine.
It was incredible.
I know.
Here's another thing.
Wait, so we've got some more, but we have to sell more couches.
Okay.
So can we come back and finish up?
Oh.
Or else Patty's going to throw something at me.
Oh.
Yep.
More. Wait a minute. Did anybody buy the couches the first time?
I don't know. We're going to find out
after.
We
still have more to sell.
Yes, we have more to sell. But okay, we'll be right back we'll finish this up.
Okay.
I'm a bad guy. Duh.
If you're thinking of selling your home, have Phil Nordella come out and give you a free, no obligation, property valuation. Just call 661-312-3561. It's that simple.
Let's talk about insurance. Are your rates skyrocketing year after year? Or do you feel like you would benefit from a professional advisor that works for you? Give the great team at Voy Insurance Solutions a call. Voy works with dozens of the best insurance companies to help you obtain competitive rates and comprehensive coverage. Homeowners, auto, business, and life insurance. Voy Insurance. Right price, right coverage, right now. Mention the Phil Nordella Show and get a free $10 Starbucks card. Visit voyinsurance.com. That's voyinsurance.com. Castle Inspection is the top choice for home inspection in Santa Clarita. With over 20 years' experience, make Castle Inspection your choice when buying your new condominium or home. From mobile homes to mansions, the outhouse to the penthouse, your best bet is a net from Castle Inspection. An inspection is a fair and objective evaluation of the home's physical and mechanical systems. Expert knowledge, thorough research, and clear communication are what sets a net at Castle above the rest. Schedule your appointment online now at castleinspection.com.
If you're looking for an SCV-based home design firm you can trust, look no further. Style My Space is a recognized leader in luxury vacant home staging and interior design projects for all of Northern Los Angeles County since 2006. Their five-star reputation for beautiful staging installations helps sellers realize up to 10% higher offers in as little as one-third the time as non-staged homes. Get an instant quote on our website at stylemyspace.com. That's stylemyspace.com.
Are you confused with all the craziness that's going on with the real estate market these days? Well, if you are, you're not alone. I'm Phil Nordella, and I have the knowledge and experience to help guide you through all the confusion. I'll answer your questions and help advise you so that you can accomplish your real estate goals. You can call me directly at 661-312-3561 or get online at philnordella.com. And don't forget, you can always listen to my radio show called Real Estate It's That Simple here on KHTS every Friday morning at 10 a.m. Phil Nordella, EXP Realty, it's that simple.
Your.
I love it.
Right on.
Your hometown station.
Okay, hey, welcome back. We're just going to pick it up where we left off. Yes, that's right. It's Real Estate. It's That Simple on KHTS 1220 AM and 98.1 FM and on Facebook Live. You know, we never waved. Hi.
We did wave last time.
Oh.
And shout out to Triple G who's listening.
Triple G.
He's listening. Yay. Who said I need to start packing for him. So that's a whole nother conversation. So thanks for bringing that up.
Oh, well, I've got a lot of things that Judy does that.
Nope. And as we were talking about people thinking about switching careers, getting into real estate, I think this is interesting.
Here's another interesting thing is for the longest time, and I don't know exactly how it's done now. I paid like $50 for errors and omissions. Don't even know what the deductible is because I've never had a claim in 29 years.
So
it doesn't really matter to me.
That's good.
But this is what we had when we were working with my old company.
Okay.
They would pay so much per deal,
okay,
right? And but the deductible was at $10,000.
Okay.
Okay.
In what year?
Because
that's a lot.
Yeah.
That's a pretty high deductible.
Yeah. Well, it also depended on just exactly, you know, because the company actually writes a policy through a major supplier. And depending on how many claims you've had yeah. like the last year. Sometimes they raise it to where our deductible was $10,000 to keep our because we wanted to be able to say, hey, if you want to work for us, you know, all it's going to cost you is this much per deal. Right. So to keep it down, obviously.
And so for people listening, errors and omissions. So if Phil, who's selling me or is selling my house or yes. whatnot in this situation, if he does something quote unquote wrong, yes. right, then he has an insurance policy that will cover him if I decide to sue him.
Yep. If yep. I make an error or I make an omission, yep. I forget to say something exactly. and they take you to court, you do have some kind
then
of insurance.
You've got, but exactly.
The insurance
coverage.
Basically is saying that, you know, if you get reamed, I mean, I've heard of people losing $200,000-$300,000 in a lawsuit.
Yeah.
Right.
That's
and so
depends on
but
what
here,
the policy.
Here's the interesting thing, the way they work it out is the insurance companies will actually go, okay, there is a claim, blah, 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 blah. And they'll say, guess what? We worked it out and it's only going to be $10,000. And so the insurance company doesn't pay a dime, but the realtor's out there $10,000.
For the deductible.
Right? And that's
yeah.
exactly what they do. They just say, okay, it's $10,000. How's that mm-hmm. sound? The people go, yeah, we'll take 10. Okay, great. So they tell the agent, write them a $10,000.
So that's something else to think about as
that's
well.
Another
but
thing
that's
to
another
think about,
cost. Yeah.
yeah. So here are a few takeaways. Understand that that it's going to take you many, many months before you make any money. Now, there are some people that just fall into this thing. And all of a sudden they say, I got licensed and guess what? You know, half of my neighbors have already said that they want me to list their house. So what do I do? I'm like, unbelievable.
Must
okay.
be nice.
If you're yeah. lucky enough to have a group of people that, that want to do business with you as soon as you get your license, hey, good.
That's great.
That's honest.
But don't expect that.
And it's... also be honest with them and let them know that you really don't know what you're doing.
But don't say it that way.
And people don't. people, yeah, I really have no idea what I'm doing, which cracks me up that people, the public, really think that as soon as you get your license, you're a realtor. And
right.
it's like, no. Okay, you need to sign on with a company that has extensive training and that you'll make a commitment to not only go to their classes, but you have to reach out and actually train besides that. Those training courses usually are two training classes, 2 hours a week, you know, 2 hours on Tuesday, 2 hours on Thursday. You have to be a constant life learner when it comes to real estate.
Well,
and you've got to do hours and hours
yeah,
and hours.
It's always evolving, ever yep. changing, as is the market, and you have to stay up with it. So,
exactly
yeah.
right. Another thing, make sure your mentor or trainer is not just a failed agent. We explain
right,
that.
Right,
be
right.
patient. And hopefully you will explain the business to your significant other. I get a lot of this.
Okay.
You know what? I'm really doing my damnedest, but I got to tell you something. My husband's like going, what the hell? I told you it wasn't going to work and da-da-da-da-da. And I slipped that one in.
It's fine.
No,
but I think that's an important part, too.
It is.
Business is not, you know, you didn't get a job. You're getting a paycheck every 2 weeks,
yep.
right? It's different. And that's something to discuss as a family, of course.
Exactly right. And
yeah.
if you ever have any questions that you'd like to actually ask me about changing careers, I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. I'll be honest with you. You know, it's not going to be all sunshine and roses. You can just call me at 661-312-3561. Now, what else do we have? We've got almost...
that was good. So we were basically discouraging people from getting into the real estate.
Well, you know what? But okay, so here's the good news. The good news is I've loved this business for the last 28 years.
Absolutely.
I mean, that's the second profession that I would have liked to have used for my life, and I'm really happy about it.
Of
right?
course.
And
it's not
been,
for everyone, and
it's
not
very
necessarily as glamorous as it seems.
Exactly right.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Good considerations to think about.
Yes. So you know what? We're not even going to get to the next one. But
I know we're not.
So we're doing Thanksgiving on Sunday for our first one.
Your first one.
Yep.
Very
yeah,
nice.
Nick and Lance are in town, and Chris and Jillian and the kids are going to come out, and we're going to do that, and maybe even put up our Christmas decorations.
Which you have been pining for since September.
Crazy
person. Triple G's birthday is on Thanksgiving.
Oh, no way. Aww. On Thanksgiving?
On Thanksgiving this year.
Oh.
Yep.
You going to get him a turkey?
I'll get him whenever he wants. It's within reason.
whoa.
When he's listening. Within reason. He's flying, unfortunately.
Oh.
So.
But happy Birthsgiving.
Yeah. Yeah. Birthsgiving. I know, right? So
that's
funny.
Clever.
Yeah. That is
good.
Good
for you.
Yeah.
Hey, so if we wanted to get a hold of you, what would we do?
Go to our website at dywlaw.com or give me a call at 661-259-9000. And same thing if we want to find you when you're not Thanksgiving-ing or
yes.
buying Christmas decorations.
Yes. 661-312-3561 or just go to philnordella.com.
And any questions people have about getting into the industry, I would definitely recommend giving Phil a call.
Just for fun.
Just do it, absolutely.
Yep.
Well, thank you everybody for listening.
Yes.
Have a great weekend.
See you next week.